Ensuring that your data is up to date is obviously very important. And if you are not regularly refreshing your page or going to other pages and returning, you can find that data is changed by someone else updating it and you're not seeing the latest version. So as an example here, I have sofa as my description, but on my other screen, I have the back end of the database and I'm going to change that to read sofa1. So I've updated that, but it doesn't automatically pull through here unless I refresh the page. Now, obviously I could come up to the top left-hand corner and refresh my whole page, which redraws everything. The other way around that is to simply click on search without using any keyword, and that will re-render the table and update my information. But that's not necessarily the most intuitive method. So you could put a button here with one line of JavaScript to have a refresh on the table. So if I change sofa1 to sofa2, I can now click on refresh and that will fetch the table again and update my data. So to do this is really straightforward. In the pages section, you have a menu and I have a button on here. You just need to make sure you add it as a link to a URL. And this refresh button has one snippet of code in it. And the only thing you need to change is your view number. On this particular page, this is view 999, as has been seen in the top of the URL. So both those methods are great to give the user an easy way to refresh their page without doing a full page refresh. But another method would be to have the page automatically reload this table on a timer. So up until I found KTL, I used to use a snippet of JavaScript to do that. So if you head over into your JavaScript section, you can paste this code in and simply change the view numbers here and here. And then I've changed it to 5,000 millisecond refresh, which is actually 5 seconds, not 15. And if I save that and then go back to my live app and do a refresh, this table will be now being fetched every 5 seconds. So in the back end, I'm going to change sofa2 to sofa3 and then come back here, not click on anything, and then this should update on a 5 second refresh. There we go. So this is now refetching the data every 5 seconds. The only disadvantage with using the JavaScript one is obviously I have to put that code for each table into the JavaScript section. But moreover, it doesn't stop the search by keyword resetting. So if I was trying to search for a record in here, such as kitchen, when I click into the search by keyword, you can see after a few seconds, it deselects when it refreshes the table. So as I start to type, it will reset my search term before I often get to the end of the word. So what I use now is KTL. So if you haven't seen any of the videos about setting it up, there are a few on this channel. So definitely worth exploring KTL, and then you can use some of the great keywords. And one of the ones I'm going to show you here is the AR equals. So auto refresh equals, and then N is the amount of numbers. And there are tons of different keywords in here, and I'll show you this one and also the timestamp. So I'm going to remove the JavaScript and save that. Come back over to my pages and this is my table. So I'm going to click on the table, go to settings, scroll down to the description, and you can put this in the title. I prefer to put it in the description, underscore AR, and I'm going to go with 5 seconds just for illustration purposes. It's probably more sensible to have this refresh in every 30 or 60 seconds, but this will just show you how it refreshes automatically on a very short timer. So back over to the live app, I've done a browser refresh now, and I'm going to change sofa3 in the back end to sofa4 and press submit, and then come back here and just wait for that to update on the timer, which it has. But what would be a really great thing is to have a timestamp here to show when the last time this table was refreshed. Well, once again, using KTL, we have a short code, the timestamp, which does look initially a little bit complicated, but I'll walk you through this. Back over to my component where I have AR and go into settings and I put it underneath. And what this is saying is it's timestamp equals and the prefix is the label. So the label will be last refreshed and then the format is day, day, month, year, hour, minute, second. So I'm going to save that. So now after a refresh, you can see my last refresh date stamp is refreshing every 5 seconds. The last thing to do is you might want to just change the CSS formatting of this, and it's a very simple snippet of code. You can simply paste this into the CSS section and change the color and the font size to suit. I'll put a link to this in the description. Save this, back to your live app and do a refresh, and you now have a more subtle timestamp here refreshing every 5 seconds. I'm just going to go back into the component and change that to every minute, so 60 seconds. So I could go into this table here and go to the settings and do exactly the same, just say underscore AR equals 60, and this table will also refresh on a 60 second, and I can put the same timestamp on here as well if I wish. So that's it. That's a few ways of being able to update your data and make sure you're always up to date. If you enjoyed this, give me a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and I'll catch you on the next one.